Kaylee, congratulations on your victory via split decision. You retained two titles and earned another one. Perhaps not the performance you expected. No. Analyze it.
I mean, you know, she came up and she was hitting hard and she was really aggressive as we planned. You know how to make adjustments. I got a little tired, but you know, you just go back to the drawing board and work on my engine and work on more stuff. You know what I mean? We always have plans, but you know, we got to use all the tools, and at the end of the day, you just got to fight and win.
Absolutely. So talk about those plans, because you started in the first round by going southpaw and you switched. What was the game plan?
You know, I just been adjusting to southpaw. I've hurt my hands in the past. I mean, like I said, I'm 13 years plus in the game. So we just figured we'd come out, try something a little different, you know, just get a little adjusted. I'm able to switch, so we tried something a little different.
In the later rounds, you made an adjustment. In the earlier rounds, perhaps it was a little tough.
Yeah.
She was coming down, moving up from a different weight class.
Yeah.
Do you think the speed was a factor?
I mean, we knew she was fast. I had to be, you know, on my game plan. It's just a little awkward. So getting my timing down and getting my distance down was a little, you know, a little adjustment. You know, you always have a plan. You know, Mike tests until you get punched in the mouth, but we always have a plan until you're in front of the fighter. So we just had to use the experience and all the tools, and we got the job done. I mean, whether it was the performance I wanted or not, again, I want to improve every single fight, and that's what we're going to do.
Absolutely. In the later rounds, you were coming back. What was going through your mind in that ninth and especially 10th round when you were really landing a lot of punches?
Man, you're gonna have to kill me to get to the goal that I set for myself. And again, a lot of times it's not pretty. We can look pretty on the pads, on the bag, but at the end of the day, we just got to fight. And I knew it was really way too close to my comfort, too close to my corner's comfort, and I just had to dig down deep and land the harder punches, land more of the punches, and just really be smart.
And finally, you got a chance face-to-face with your future opponent, Chantelle Cameron. You got to see her face-to-face in the ring. How did it feel? How do you see this fight playing out in 2022?
It's going to be a war. I mean, I was there for her last fight, and I know she was there just like I was at her fight, taking notes. And, you know, every fighter makes you fight different, so it's going to be a different fight, different plan with her. I'm excited. I'm not like, oh, man, this is what I signed up for. I didn't sign up to, you know, have tea time. I signed up to fight and be undisputed. The time is now, so I'm excited. Let's get it done. You know what I mean? She calls herself a real champ. We don't got to do it in the U.K. We can do it in the U.S. You know what I mean? She fought in Vegas already. I haven't, so, you know, let's get it done.
And finally, a message to all your supporters after your victory today.
Man, Katabatasha means thank you for all my fans, my supporters. I fight for all nations. I fight for you. Stop line three. You know, find our children and stop stealing our women, missing and murdering indigenous women. Stand strong, Ayutosh, and it's Happy Native American Heritage Month.
Thank you.
Thank you.